Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jaya Radha Madha, Radha Madha, Radha Madha, Jaya Radha Madha. Jaya Pancha Tattva, Pancha Tattva, Pancha Tattva, Jaya Pancha Tattva. Jai Jai Prabhupada, 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 Jai Prabhupada. Jai Sri Radha Madhava Sakhi Vrinda Ki पंचतत्व भगवान की प्रहलाद नृसिंहदेव भगवान की जगत गुरु श्रील प्रभुपाद की श्रीमद्भागवत महापुराण की समवेद भक्त वृंद की नितय गौर प्रेमानंद हरि हरि बोल हरे कृष्ण। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग भागवतम क्लास आई वुड लाइक टू टेक permission and blessings from senior Vaishnavas assembled here, especially His Grace Jananivas Prabhu, my Saksha Guru. Hare Krishna. Today we are going to discuss from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter 3, Text Number 44. So if you have sloka, you can try to repeat. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Tatra Kirtayato Vipra Viprarshe Burite Jasha. अहम चाद्य गमम तत्र निविष्टस्तदनो ग्रहान् सोहं यः श्रावयिष्यामि यथाधीतं यथामति तत्र कीर्तयतो विप्रा विप्रर्षे भूरि तेजसः अहं चाद्य गमं तत्र निविष्टस्तदनो ग्रहा सोऽहं वः श्रावयिष्यामि यथाधीतं यथामति तत्र कीर्तयतो विप्रा विप्रर्षि भूरि तेजसः अहं चाद्य गमं तत्र निविष्टस्तदनो ग्रहा सोऽहं श्रावयिष्यामि यथाधीतं यथामति यस् प्लीज तत्र कीर्तयतो विप्रा विप्रर्षे भूरि तेजसः गमं तत्र तत्र कीर्तयतो विप्रा गमं तत्र निविष्टस्तदनो ग्रहा सोऽम्ब श्रावयिष्यामि यथाधीतं यथामति तत्र कीर्तयतो विप्रा विप्रर्षि भूरि तेजसः अहं चाद्य गमं तत्र निविष्टस्तदनो ग्रहा सोऽम्बस्रावयिष्यामि यथाधीतं यथामति हरे कृष्ण वट् वट् मीनिङ्ग् तत्र देर् कीर्तयत वैल् रिसैटिङ्ग् विप्रा ओ ब्राह्मणास् Viprarshe, from the great Brahmana Rishi. Bhuri, greatly. Tejasa, powerful. Aham, I. Cha, also. Adhyagamam, could understand. Tatra, in that meeting. Nivishta, being perfectly attentive. तदनुग्रह बाय हिज मर्सी स दैट वेरी थिंग अहम आय व अंटू यू श्रावयिष्यामि सर लेट यू हियर यथाधीतम यथामति एज फार एज माय रियलाइजेशन ट्रांसलेशन ओ लर्नेड ब्राह्मण व्हेन सुखदेव गोस्वामी रिसाइटेड भागवतम देन इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एम्परर परीक्षित आई हर्ड हिम विथ रैप्ड अटेंशन एंड दस बाय हिज मर्सी आई लर्नेड द भागवतम फ्रॉम दैट ग्रेट एंड पावरफुल सेज Now I shall try to make you hear the very same thing I learned from it, from him, and as have realized it. Okay, you can please repeat. O learned Brahmanas, when Sukadeva Goswami recited Bhagavatam, there in the presence of Emperor Parikshit, I heard him with rapt attention. And thus, by his mercy, I learned the Bhagavatam from that great and powerful sage. Now I shall try to make you hear the very same thing as I have realized it. Purport. One can certainly see directly the presence of Lord Sri Krishna in the pages of Bhagavatam if one has heard it from a self-realized great soul like Sukadev Goswami. One cannot, however, learn Bhagavatam from a bogus hired reciter whose aim of life is to earn some money out of such recitation and employ the earning in sex indulgence. No one can learn Srimad Bhagavatam who is associated with persons engaged in sex life. That is the secret of learning Bhagavatam. Nor can one learn Bhagavatam from one who interprets the text by his mundane scholarship. One has to learn Bhagavatam from the representative of Sukadev Goswami and no one else. If one at all wants to see Lord Krishna in the pages, that is the process and there is no alternative. Sut Goswami is a bona fide representative of Sukadev Goswami because he wants to present the message which is received from the great learned Brahmana. Sukadeva Goswami presented Bhagavatam as he heard it from his great father. And so also Sut Goswami, in presenting Bhagavatam as he had heard it from Sukadeva Goswami. Simply hearing is not all. One must realize the text with proper attention. The word Nivishta means that Sut Goswami drank the juice of Bhagavatam through his ears. That is the real process of receiving Bhagavatam. One should hear with rapt attention from the real person and then he can at once realize the presence of Lord Krishna in every page. The secret of knowing Bhagavatam is mentioned here. No one can give rapt attention who is not pure in mind. No one can be pure in mind who is not pure in action. No one can be pure in action who is not pure in eating, sleeping, fearing and mating. But somehow or other, if someone hears with rapt attention from the right person, at the very beginning one can assuredly see Lord Sri Krishna in person in the pages of Bhagavatam. Thus end the Bhaktivedanta purports of the first canto, third chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam, entitled Krishna is the source of all incarnations. Hare Krishna. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah. Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam. Vandeham Sri Guru Sri Uta Padakamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Shagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Shaitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sagana Lalita Sri Vrishakanvitamscha. Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pradishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Name. Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharane Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschat Deshtarane. Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vashadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada telling us how to see Krishna in every page of Bhagavatam. That is the message of this purport. How to see Krishna even in person. See Lord Krishna in person in the pages of Bhagavatam. So how to see Krishna in person in the pages of Bhagavatam. Because Bhagavatam is non-different from Krishna. Krishna Swadham Upagati Dharma Jnana Adivisha Kalonashta Drishamesha Punar Arkodhunodita. Srimad Bhagavatam is incarnation of Krishna in Sabda Brahma incarnation. So Bhagavatam is non-different from Krishna itself, plus every sloka, every word of Bhagavatam is a glorification of Radha Krishna. So with rapt attention, if we hear from the realized soul, then we may develop that quality to see Krishna in every page of Bhagavatam. How to see Krishna every page of Bhagavatam? That is the process Prabhupada is mentioning here. Prabhupada very systematically mentions here that what it requires. First, it says that one who is indulged in sex life, if we hear from him, will not work. He also mentions before that if a reciter is earning earning to indulgent sex, if he's earning for his maybe maintenance, that is not mentioned here. If he's earning and using that money for sense gratification, that is condemned, what it appears from the PowerPoint. And those who are living for serving Krishna and free from these four sinful activities which are mentioned here, we hear from them, we can learn. Now, here, the word Nivishta means that Suta Goswami drank juice of Bhagavatam through ears. That is the real process of receiving Bhagavatam. One should hear the with rapt intention from a real person. Then he can realize the presence of Lord Krishna in every page. The secret of knowing Bhagavatam mentioned here, now secret Prabhupada revealing the secret. No one can give rapt intention if he is not pure in mind. If our mind is impure, we will not be able to give attention to Bhagavatam. What will happen? Our mind will go here and there. When we were listen to Bhagavatam, our mind will wander some other subjects. Because pure Bhagavatam, our mind needs some kind of masala. Pure Bhagavatam, mind will not like it. But mind needs some kind of food for some passion, some ignorance. So that's why first this mind is not pure, then one will not be able to hear Bhagavatam with rapt attention. Like in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Bhogeshwara Prasaktana, Taya Aparita Chetasam, Vyasatmika Buddhi Samadho Navidyate. The Samadho means concentration. So one cannot concentrate on spiritual subject if one's mind is wandering in material sense objects. So that Prabhupada says, rapt intention can only be possible if one is pure in mind. The next comes, one can be pure in mind only if one's actions are pure. If one is not pure in action. So pure in action means, if I'm whole day I indulge in sense gratification or material activity, and if I sit for 2 hours for chanting Hare Krishna or hearing Bhagavatam, then I'm not able to concentrate because my actions are not pure. If I'm engaged in sakam karma, how my mind will not help me during chanting or hearing Bhagavatam? Then one's actions cannot be pure. No one can be pure in action if one is not pure in eating. So pure in eating means taking Krishna prasadam, eating Krishna prasadam. Pure in sleeping. Pure in sleeping means to sleep, to get proper rest, to next day we can work for Krishna. That should be the purpose of sleeping. So that is pure in sleeping. Like while sleeping, we may think that let me take sufficient rest so tomorrow I can serve Krishna. So that is pure sleep. Then pure in fearing. This is actually Ahar Nidra Bhaya Method, that Prabhupada translated it like this. Eating, sleeping, fearing and mating. So fearing is Atmaraksha. So pure in Atmaraksha, fear and mating. Pure in mating means only doing sex with religious principles and regulations. That is pure in mating. So if one is pure in these four actions, Prabhupada says, if one is pure in these four activities, Ahar, Nidra, Bhaya, Maithun, then he will be pure in action. And if one is pure in action, then he will be able pure in mind. and one is pure in mind, then you can hear Srimad Bhagavatam and you can see on each page Sri Krishna present. Once I was speaking to Bhakti Dhir Damodar Maharaj in Kolkata. He came once and I met him. I was talking to him. So Bhakti Dhir Damodar Maharaj, he's very, you have seen his lecture, very serious, very strict. So I went to him to just talk to him. So he was telling me, like, when he reads Bhagavatam, he said he sits in front of Bhagavatam as if, no, he's sitting in front of deity, Krishna. Then he said that when he's reading Bhagavatam, each page, each line, if he's reading from purport, so he feels that Prabhupada is speaking to him, to Maharaj. Like that he reads. And he reads sloka, say, Sukadev Uvacha. So he feels that Sukadev Goswami is speaking to him. Like this. He said, so much aware and conscious while reading Bhagavatam. Like we read and our minds do not like that. Fully conscious of each sentence, each word. Like this he was saying that, like, as we go to no altar for worshipping deity, how much we are conscious? That type of no consciousness while reading Bhagavatam. He Maharaj presents like that. So very spiritual. That is the way we can read. Now I will just we discuss the sloka. Let's see the sloka. Very, very nice sloka. Tatra kirtayo vipra kirtayato vipra viprashri bhuri tejas. Aham chadagamam tatra nivishtastad anugrahat. Soham vasravishyami yathaditam yathamati. Sut Goswami is telling to his audience the history of Bhagavatam, how the Bhagavatam came. So which is already discussed, I will not repeat that. But he is saying that tatra, then, there means on the bank of Jamuna or Ganga, where Sukadev Goswami spoke Bhagavatam to Parikshit Maharaj. In that place where Bhagavatam took place first time, I was also there. Coincidentally, I also happened to be there. Sut Goswami is saying, Tatra kirtayato vipra viprarshe bhuri tejas. So who was reciting? The bhuri tejas, very powerful, great sage Sukadev Goswami. He was reciting. So I was so fortunate to be there. Like sometime, no? We think that, are, some people say, Prabhupada was giving lecture and I attended, like one, they remember whole life. I was so fortunate to see him, like people say their story. Well, such and such Maharaj was speaking and I was attended. So Sut Goswami remembering that Sukadev Goswami, such a great and powerful sage, spoke Bhagavatam for Parikshit Maharaj. But I was fortunate to be there. I was sitting there. Aham cha adhyagamam tatra. I also attended that Bhagavatam. Adhyagamam is studied. I studied Bhagavatam. With rapt attention, he studied Bhagavatam. Adhyagamam. Nivishta tad anugrahat. Nivishta means I entered. Prabhupada said drinking the juice of Bhagavatam. Nivishta means drinking the juice of Bhagavatam. So Sut Goswami was able to drink Bhagavatam when he heard from Sukadev Goswami. How he was able? Tad anugrahat. By the mercy of Sukadev Goswami. Because without the mercy of Guru or the person who is speaking, we won't be able to enter into Bhagavatam and drink the nectar of Bhagavatam. So that's why generally whoever speaks Bhagavatam, we pay full respect to that person and we in our heart put them as our Vyasasana, accept him as a guru for time being. So the mercy flows through that guru parampara. So tad anugrahat, Sut Goswami, he was also not ordinary. He was son of Romarshana. He was also a learned scholar, Sut Goswami himself. But Sukhdev Goswami is Mahabhagavat. So he heard from Sukhdev Goswami, and by his mercy, he heard the Bhagavatam. So first he's telling his own qualification. Sut Goswami is telling his own qualification of speaking Bhagavatam, because it is just introduction. Now these chapters are introduction to Bhagavatam. Here the introduction of the speaker, introduction of the audience, that is going on in whole first canto. Just introduction to Sukhdev Goswami, who is a great speaker. Introduction to Parikshit Maharaj, that is the first canto. Introducing all the main men, audience and characters. So he is introducing himself. How is he introducing? What is the proper introduction? Just, I am a good disciple of such and such person. I have heard the Bhagavatam from Sukhdev Goswami. That is my qualification. So that is his putting, that I heard from Sukhdev Goswami, and I heard it with rapt attention. So that is the qualification. Second, third qualification, he is saying, I nivished, I was able to drink the juice of Bhagavatam. So that's why I'll be able to make you all also drink the same nectar which I heard from Sukhdev Goswami. Then the very important two words are there in the sloka, that is yathadhitam yathamati. Very important. Yathadhitam means as I have understood. Adhitam, study. Yathamati, as far as my intelligence goes, up to that I will explain. So what does it mean? If I heard something, if I have not understood it, better not to speak. Yatha adhita means as I have understood, as I have learned it. So if I have not understood, better not to speak. Means knowledge itself is not sufficient. There are three things, knowledge, understanding and realization. In learning, in study, we have three things: knowledge, understanding and realization, application. So only knowledge is not sufficient. There should be understanding also. So as far as my understanding, I will speak. And yatha mati. Mati means intelligence. So what is the intelligence? Why intelligence has to be used? Yes, intelligence need to be used while speaking Bhagavatam. Yatha mati and yatha adhitam. So yatha adhitam is as I understood or as I realized. But yatha mati means this is called a philosophical speculation. That is called yatha mati. Yatha mati means using our intelligence for philosophical speculation. So we are not allowed to do mental speculation, but we are allowed to do philosophical speculation. There is difference between mental speculation and philosophical speculation. Philosophical speculation is always welcome, it's allowed, but mental speculation is not allowed. So what is the difference between the two? Like all our acharyas, they give philosophical speculation and the conclusion in each purport, in many different commentaries you'll find philosophical speculation. So what is this philosophical speculation? Like Krishna is saying, Dehino asmin yatha dehe kaumaram yavanam jana. So we have to speculate it. We have to meditate, contemplate. Okay, Dehino asmin, Dehi means Atma, not the body. Inside the body someone is there, he is called Dehi. Name is not given, who is, we don't know, but whoever is inside the body, Dehi, that Dehi no asmin yatha Dehi, in the body, kaumaram yavanam jana. So you speculate, Kumar, okay. One child is there, then he should become young, becoming old. Okay, like this. Kumara Myotatha Dehantara Prabhu. Then he changes the body. So, like this. Then there is comparison between two slokas. You keep one sloka here, keep another sloka here. And then you have to compare two slokas. You have to compare two different spiritual levels. Say, Jnana Yoga and Dhyana Yoga. You have to compare. What is the difference between two? What is the similarity? So these are called philosophical speculation. But philosophical speculation will never go any existing Siddhanta. You have to maintain all the Siddhanta, keeping intact all the Siddhanta, then you have to speculate. And that speculation is required actually. But mental speculation is not allowed. Mental speculation is something which is not mentioned in the scripture. You are your own speculating something. Yeah? That is mental speculation. So here, yatha adhitam yatha mati. As I have understood, and as my intelligence will allow, that much I will explain to you. Soham vasraveshyami yatha adhitam yatha mati. So this very nice Sut Goswami, Sut Goswami is telling to all his audience that Tatra Kirtayatu, Kirtayatu. He was doing Kirtan, Sukhdev Goswami. So Bhagavatam is something to do with Kirtan. Means he recited it. Word Kirtan is mentioned. Means he recited it loudly, so everyone can hear nicely. And he was singing. Bhagavatam is supposed to be sang. The slokas, that's why I meant particular meter, so one can sing it. So he was singing the sloka, and there was blissful kirtan of Bhagavatam, and it was like nectarian to all the ears of the audience. Sometime back, some devotee commented, I want just this because it came in mind. I want to. Some devotee commented that at that time there was no mic system. So how can 60,000 people hear? So it was no subtle transformation of sound. And this is bogus because the lips must be used in kirtan. It cannot be without. You keep your mouth closed and subtle sound is, that is not good. And Bhagavatam, every time they said one should hear from the ears. Hundreds of times in mentioned in Bhagavatam that one should fill ears with the sound vibration. So it is not subtle transformation. It was loud kirtan and people could hear through the ears. It's spoken by mouth, heard through ears. It is not the subtle transformation of sound. That is wrong conclusion, wrong philosophical. This is called mental speculation. That some devotee commented like that, no? That time they were very mystic. They have mystic perfection, Sukhdev Goswami, all the sages. So without speaking, they could understand. There was, sound was transformed, transferred to them. So that is not correct. He properly recited, he sang it with his mouth. They heard it with the ears. That is the process. So our all Acharya stressing in this point, that we have to use our tongue and ears. Very important to engage tongue and ear in Krishna's kirtan. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Thank you very much. I covered most of the points which are there in the purport. Any question? Welcome, Chiva Prabhu. Nice, at least you gave darshan at the end. Blessing. Any question? There is 10 minutes. Yes, Prabhu.
Here that Sutta Goswami is saying that he will Hare Krishna.
The Sutta Goswami may understand less and then less and less. Does it mean that through the parampara we're getting less and less? Because understanding of the basically like Sutta Goswami is like lesser than the Shukadeva Goswami. Is that correct or no?
Okay. The Prabhu's question is that when it comes down, it becomes less or not? That's the question. Like in what you're saying, that is mentioned in Bhagavad Gita, Sakaleneha Mahata Yoga Nashta Paramtapa. No, that Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, you know, 4.2, that this Bhagavad Gita was coming down due to time that it could destroy. But we cannot actually conclude that previous one is higher and the later one is lower. We cannot make such conclusion. Sometime, maybe Sukhdev Goswami, see, and Vyasdev. Vyasdev is father, guru of Sukhdev Goswami, but Sukhdev Goswami is not less than Vyasdev, isn't it? So, it will depend on the person. You will receive the knowledge from the higher. Now, it's up to you how much sincerely you are practicing it, and accordingly you will get realization. You may be equal, you may be lesser. And if you want to become higher, you will get mercy from some other sources. Yeah, Adebo.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Adebo. Prabhu, at one place I heard this shloka. Aham vetti, suko vetti, vyasa vetti, na vetti va. So, how it is like Vyasadeva, it's like Lord Shiva is telling that maybe he might be knowing or not. So why about Vyasadeva it has been told like this? So can you please explain?
This sloka is spoken by Shivji, yeah?
Yes.
Shivji saying, Shiva saying, Aham Veti, Sukho Veti, Vyaso Veti, Naveti Va. About Bhagavatam. I don't know also. I know this sloka. What I can say is that maybe this is spoken something with very confidential of some Radha Krishna's confidential matter which Vyasadeva may not enter into. Sukhdev Goswami or Lord Shiva can enter there, but Vyasadeva may not be, because Vyasadeva is also incarnation. Shaktyavesh Avatar. So Shaktyavesh Avatar is incarnation for writing the books, all the Bhagavatam, etc. But he doesn't have to be get into Radha Krishna, Golok Vrindavan, inside Golok, not required. As an incarnation, he can be any place in the creation. But Sukhdev Goswami is inside there. So he knows better, more. And Shiva is also is going there, almost up to there. So he also knows. Vyasa is not required to go there. Adebo.
Okay, thank you, Prabhu.
This is my philosophical speculation.
You mean Vyasadev had no access to Rasa Leela, rather Sukhdev Goswami?
No require, I mean. If he wish, he will follow the process and he can enter. But as an incarnation, he has his own place where to be.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Any other? Prabhu, want to comment on this? You heard this sloka? Aham veti, sukho veti, vyaso veti, na veti va.
Well, I think here they summarize the situation of the whole material existence and spiritual existence. Prabhupada just put it down to sex life. About three times he mentions it's sex life or the Srimad Bhagavatam. If you associate with people who have sex, that's equally as bad. So there's Prabhupada summarizes, you've got sex, which means the material world, and you've got Bhagavatam, which actually means the spiritual world. And in Bhagavatam you have to hear it through the parampara, which
I will repeat what Prabhu said. Prabhu said that in the purport, Prabhupada has mentioned few very important points. One point is that he has defined very clearly, one side is sex life and one side is spiritual life. So one, there is sex life one side, and on the other side you can hear the Bhagavatam and see Krishna in Bhagavatam. These two is two different lines. Yes, Brahm.
Then Krishna will jump out through the pages, Prabhupada mentions here. I used to have the service of reading Krishna book for Radha Madhava every night before when they were taking rest. It was most temples would do that in the early days. I think Prabhupada introduced that also. And one time I was reading out Krishna. I think he was going to visit Mathura or somewhere, but he's with his entourage, and there was all the camel train and all the big procession was there, and the military was there and everything like that. And I was reading it, and I actually, it kind of jumped out the page, the whole scene with all the people going in a big procession, all of Krishna and Balaram were there, I think they were sitting on Jasoda's lap or something like that. But actually for a moment, the picture, it came out of the page, the actual procession as they were walking along the grand procession.
This was in altar? In the altar?
Yeah, on the altar, yeah.
Haribo. I'll say what Prabhupada said, I will just proceed and repeat. Prabhu was... He's saying that how we can see Krishna in the pages of Bhagavatam. He's telling about that. So Prabhu's service was to read Krishna book for Radha Madhav. Prabhu was every day used to go to Radha Madhav and read Krishna book before sleeping. Before making Radha Madhav sleep, Prabhu used to read Bhagavatam, Krishna book. So while he was reading Krishna book, one day he was reading about Krishna's traveling. Krishna was traveling with all his friends and big entourage, you know, when Krishna traveling from Dwaraka to here and there. So, lot of entourage. So, while reading, suddenly his picture came up. Like what he was reading, they have to picturize entire thing. How Krishna. So, that is how Prabhu saying that can see Krishna in the pages of Bhagavatam. So, you could see. Like fully in dhyana or in real physical world or in your meditation, how you feel. So
I was reading it in the book, but I saw the picture in my mind, kind of came to life within my mind.
So I just asked question, you understood. So yes, it by reading first the picture came in mind. That then Prabhu says become almost like live in like dhyan. Like it appeared almost live then. He saw that all entire entourage of Krishna.
Yeah, so it's Krishna's mercy. We read the book, it's not, and he manifests. Krishna just manifests himself really.
If you read book nicely, then Krishna will, you understood, manifest. Krishna will manifest. By his mercy, he will manifest.
We will read the Bhagavatam, study the Bhagavatam, research. But Krishna will reveal the the actual import of the Bhagavatam. Or Krishna, he will reveal.
One more point you were saying. There some more points were there. Some more points were there in the purport? Something else were there?
No. Okay.
Yes, Guru.
Hare Krishna. As we hear in the purport that Sutta Goswami heard very attentively Nivishta, but like practicing practitioner like me, many times I deliberately trying to be attentive, but actually it won't work. Like mind goes to different services other than what I am doing, hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, and it goes to sleep mode. So like what could be the like shortest remedy, and like how we could sort it out? So can you please give some insight?
Prabhu's question is that how can I be attentive? That's the question. Mind is going out there. Even is Prabhu is trying to give full attention, forcing himself, but still mind going. What I can understand then, by hearing Bhagavatam, if you develop taste, when you get a ruchi, taste, then mind will not go here and there. So we need to develop taste for hearing Bhagavatam. So how one develops taste? By regularly hearing, we can develop the taste. And once the taste is there, our mind will be there. And also Prabhupada said, pure in action, pure in mind. These things are also required. So by hearing regularly, you will develop some taste in the topic itself. When the topic is interesting means you develop the taste for it, then you will not fall asleep. Also something to do with speaker also, isn't it? Always he can't blame the audience. Yes, you can, you still want to add some comment on this? Yes, sure.
Hare Krishna. This is the problem I am also facing from many months maybe. So practical solution is that we can write the writing. Whatever speaker is speaking, so mind will go here, there, because he wants something. And he wants something like that, catchy. So if you are writing, so he has to listen, he has to be attentive. And then you keep on writing and then mind will be there, and you are making some summary or you are making some points. So mind has to be there.
See, and taking notes.
See, getting notes or writing or word to word, line to line, or summary or some whatever. So mind can't go there.
This is one suggestion. But after doing that, if you develop rapt attention, then you won't be able to write, because you will enter into it. Then you won't be able to write also, because you have to give so much attention. But in beginning, this is a good idea. If mind is wandering.
Thank you.
That is our nature, right? So if you're actually enjoying reading Bhagavatam, then you'll do it. If you feel like it's a chore, it'll always be a chore. It won't be fun. So just like when Prabhupada says, when you're in kirtan, you should dance. Even if you don't feel like dancing, if you start dancing, then you'll get into it. Like, oh, this is kind of fun. Just by forcing yourself, you don't feel like reading Bhagavatam or your mind's somewhere else, by forcing yourself doing, all of a sudden you go, wow, he did that? Wow, that's so cool. I can't believe that. Wow, what's going to happen next? Your mind will then, talk you into enjoying it. And once you enjoy, because we're all enjoyers, it's easy. So, it's like we pick up, magazines when we're interested, say, in the presidential election. We'll follow that. We'll be interested. We can tell you the states won, all this kind of stuff that means nothing, but because we think we're interested in it, we'll remember it. So if we do that with our spiritual literatures, the same process will happen. We'll become excited to pick up the Bhagavatam every day. Oh, I can't wait till I get home. I can pick up my Bhagavatam and start reading and find out what Krishna's going to do or what this sage is doing or what the, So if we treat it like that, we'll get excited. And when you enjoy it, you get excited, it becomes fun, it's not a chore anymore.
So being eager, excited, and enjoying the Bhagavatam. We can end it.
I just want to add something. Like in starting, we don't have any taste for holy name. We don't know the value of Harinam, so we don't have any taste. We don't want to even do it. Even one round is a very big, heavy thing for us in the starting. So that time we force ourselves. No, I have to do one round, two first round, four
round. And then gradually get
forcing, forcing ourselves to listen the Bhagavatam. Then slowly Haribu. We will develop the taste. Same thing, Harinam and Bhagavatam.
Okay.
So little bit we have to force ourselves. Thank you.
Thank you, Madhai. Hare Krishna. So we'll end here. Jai Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Nitai Gaur Premanande Hari Ribo.